Good morning, Manshack Bay. Dandy Don here with you on a beautiful Sunday morning. The winds are picking up a little out there, creating a little trouble for the golfers participating in the annual Manshack Bay Country Club Golf Tournament. Good luck to everybody playing out there today. In other news, a dead body was found on the train tracks. Detective Liz Horowitz is on the scene and in charge, but has yet to comment on the situation.
Sir, it's just I could really use some help. There hasn't been a murder in Manshack Bay since Dr. Gonzalez's paternity clinic closed down, and I don't really know what I'm doing here. I'm just a little bit rusty at this. Gathering evidence by myself. Do we have a CSI team, sir? I know it's a show, but I think it's actually a real thing as well, sir. No, I can't handle it, sir. Swisser, he's in Hawaii, sir, on vacation. Apparently the legal age of consent there is 14. Sir, really, I think I'm contaminating some of the evidence. I'm trying to collect as much as I can. Oh, 1 second, sir. Hold on a second, sir. I found something. There was something very large and hard in his pants. Nothing, sir. Something, some kind of jewel. Yeah, I don't want to contaminate the evidence, sir. Yes, sir. Right away, sir. Oh, 76? Good for you, sir. I'm just gonna finish up here. All right. Actually, sir, it's Horowitz. The W is not silent. Sir?
Yes, indeed. Manshack Bay was in good hands that day. The captain and most of the other officers decided to enter the annual Manshack Bay Country Club Golf Tournament, making Liz the highest-ranking officer in the whole town. Liz may not have been the most experienced detective on the force, but today she had the captain's complete confidence. And in accordance with the captain's orders, Liz delivered the dead body to the morgue and then made her way to Perkins Jewelry to have the mysterious jewel checked out by Manshack Bay's finest and most respected jeweler, Sal Perkins.
Oh, hello, young lady.
Mr. Perkins, I'm Detective Horowitz from
Horowitz?
The Manshack...
Horowitz?
The W is pronounced.
Tomato, tomato. It's okay.
Horowitz. The captain wanted me to bring you this, and...
What you got here now?
About it.
It doesn't seem very valuable, but...
Sir?
It seems to be different. It's a little round. Be careful with that, young lady.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to look at this more, do a little bit more research, but I can put it in my safe for you and keep it safe until, keep it overnight for you. It'll be safe in there. That's why it's my safe.
All right.
I need to do more research. All right.
Okay.
More research on this. Okay.
All right. Let me write that down. More research. Keeping in safe. Wonder why I feel uncomfortable about this.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. I got tons of pretty things here. No one's gonna get in there. Don't worry about
that. Yeah. Oh wow.
You see something you like there?
Well.
You see something? I see you looking at that ring right there.
Well, yeah.
Oh, it's a pretty ring. Why don't you try it on?
Well, I can't afford anything like that on a detective salary.
You don't know now.
They don't even pay us. It's a volunteer
position. Look, try it on. Pretty girl needs a pretty ring, don't she?
You think I'm pretty?
Oh, yeah. Why don't you try the ring on, though?
Okay.
Oh, it feels good in your hand now, doesn't it?
Oh, my gosh, yes.
There you go. Now look how nice that makes your hand look.
Oh, my fingers look significantly less manly. How much? Oh, my God. I can't afford this.
You sure? Just put it back in there.
Thank you.
You sure?
Thank you.
You can always come back and buy it.
Well, we'll see. All right. Thank you.
Okay. All right, you have a nice day now, lady.
Mm-hmm.
boss does like a lot of red. I don't have anything against the color personally, but I think you should branch out and expand more of the color palette. It's like petting a real panther, velvety.
Minions! I need you two to pull a job for me. Tonight.
Sure, boss.
Perkins Jewelry. There's a safe. In this safe is the Eye of Laveau.
Whose eye? The left eye or the right eye?
It's a jewel, you idiots. It's a large jewel in the safe. I need you to get it and bring it to me. Don't muck this up. Don't take anything but the jewel.
Nothing.
And don't get caught.
No.
Get out of my sight.
Getting the batteries.
No, I got the flashlights. You were supposed to get the batteries.
No, I got the flashlights. You were supposed to get the batteries. No, there it is. She's a real beaut, but don't worry. There's not a safe built that I haven't been able to crack. I was head boy at Minion School, due mostly in part to the fact that I was tops at cracking safes. And the safe crackers through. What do you... You're welcome.
You're welcome for what?
Obviously, I loosened it for you.
The only thing loose around here are the screws in your head.
Look, there it is.
Let me see. Let me see.
Oh, it doesn't work.
That one's pretty here. Why don't you let me hold on to that?
Quickly. Go, go. Quickly. Is this your idea of quickly?
Oh, the boss is going to be so glad to get this thing.
Oh, I know. Oh. It's so shiny.
It is shiny. Look how pretty it is.
Can I give it to him?
Oh, no. It's okay. I'll take it to him.
No, you gave it to the last thing.
Then I'm going to give it to him again.
No,
it'll be fine.
No, it's my turn. No, I want to give it.
It's not your turn.
No.
I always bring it to him.
Why it's my turn?
No.
Before.
I'm so sorry, Mr. Perkins.
Are you kidding? The only two things they took was that jewel and that pretty ring you were looking at.
Oh.
A little suspicious, don't you think so?
Yes, very suspicious.
When I was younger, they didn't have anything like this. The cops did their job.
I'm doing the best I can.
Well, you're not doing a very good job now, are you?
It's just me.
It doesn't matter. You're young. You're young. You see me? You see me having trouble with anything?
No, remember.
Now I'll stay young. I take them fish oil pills, my wife rubs a peppermint cream on my feet at night. Keeps me spry. Maybe you should try some of that. Keep your brain a little spryer. Not doing a very good job. I mean, are you gonna take care of this?
Okay.
I can't believe you.
Number 1 1026 black latent powder, 12 ounce open.
You ever done this before?
Stan, I have.
Does not really seem like you know what you're doing.
Stand aside, Mr. Perkins, citizen.
The wood? What are you gonna pull off the wood? You dust the safe. They obviously touched the safe.
Look,
to get into the safe.
I do not tell you how to sell pawned goods to people who are pawning them. Do not tell me how to fingerprint things.
Well, obviously someone needs to tell you how to do your job. You found anything yet?
No, there's no prints.
Now these two boys just lost Viktor Shank's jewel, and Victor's not going to be very happy about that. So they've come up with an idea to replace the jewel. Now where can you go to replace the jewel at 11 o'clock at night in Manshack Bay? Where else but the boat?
This is it.
This is the one?
This is the one.
This is it.
So, which one looks mystical?
How about the one that has the little light shining on it?
Yes!
It's the closest thing I could see.
It's glowing with magical
power.
This is gonna work.
This is exactly the same way I got the engagement ring for my ex, fiance.
Oh, okay.
Trust me.
Oh, is that what happened between y'all?
Give me one more.
I don't know if I... Oh,
this is my last quarter. I have to make it count.
Here we go.
Got this.
Here we go. All right, let's see.
You got it.
Yes!
Oh, we get to live.
We're saved.
We get to live.
Sorry. Oh.
That's definitely the eye.
Looks a little bit like it.
Smaller, but you know,
a
it's
lot
still...
smaller.
But I don't think let's the boss just, has ever seen
well,
it.
I mean, yeah, he hasn't seen it. He won't know the difference.
So I'm guessing you two have something for me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's got something for you. Right here.
Here you go, boss. I believe it's the left one. That's the lucky eye, historically.
That's it? That's the one?
What? What is this?
The Eye of Laveau.
Yeah, that's it.
It's eye-shaped sized.
Do you take me for a fool? This is a child's plaything. This is not the Eye of Laveau. What happened? I knew you two would mess it up. This is it. This is the last straw. No more! You two are done! I need some new henchmen! What's the number of that temp agency?
I gave it to you.
Get me the yellow pages! Go! Get out of here!
How do you think the apartment's coming along?
Oh, I think it's great. I mean... I know you're a little disappointed in the size of it. It's quite a bit smaller than the house.
Quite a bit.
But it's great, isn't it? I mean, look at it. It's very nice. You know, we got the granite.
It is nice.
Things, those are hot right now.
Miss my home, though. I tell you what.
Yeah, I do too. But we're being positive, right?
Yeah.
We're being positive.
Very positive.
Look into the future. Mm-hmm. Things, it's just a dip, you know? And I know you support me because of my morals. I didn't want to give in to those corporate buttholes, you know?
I really wish you would have just manned up and said something.
You know, honey, I'm not a rat. Never will be. Never have been.
But you know what? Sometimes, you know, it takes a rat to get the cheese. Well, I
if a rat is only looking for cheese and, you know...
Maybe that's your cheese.
Can hurt some
maybe that's your cheese.
To get that cheese. If that's all he's thinking about. That's all I'm saying. So just get that phone. Hey, hello. Yes, yes, this is Norm. Oh, Mr. Jones for the temp agency. Hey, how are you? Yeah. Oh, you got some good news. Oh, that is super. That's super. Yeah, let me get a pen. All right. Okay, yeah, the address. Okay, got that. And Viktor Shank is who I'll be talking. Viktor Shank? Shank. Okay, yeah, no, got it. Sounds cool. Evil minion? It's an evil minion. Those are real? That's a real thing? Okay. Okay. I think I could probably, I don't know if I'm evil per se, but I could dig down deep and find something in there maybe and do a good job. It's all about doing a good job for the boss. It's okay. All right. So, you know, I don't feel very comfortable, but, how much is the, Oh, dear Lord. Okay. Yeah. All right. Yeah, I can. I'm an evil guy. I'm an evil. Suddenly I feel it in my loins. Feel it in there. It's okay. All right. Hey, I appreciate it very much. Thank you so much. All right. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. Oh.
Evil minion?
Yeah, it's weird, right?
Yeah, it is weird. You?
I know. Evil? I'm not really cut out for that. Not at all.
Viktor Shank?
Viktor Shank.
Like you're gonna shank somebody? Where did he get that? In prison?
I don't know. But if he needs an evil minion, he probably shanks people or something. Honey, there's one thing you gotta look at. That's the money. The money that... Look at that. That's how much...
I think you'd be a damn good evil minion.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really good.
Uh-huh.
Do you think Mr. Shank likes apple pie?
Oh.
I know you like my apple pie.
I love apple. I love your apple pie.
I know you do.
Out of all apple pies in the world.
You better.
Yeah. He'd probably like a blackbird pie, though.
Yeah. You think?
Evil, I would imagine. I don't know.
Is that evil?
I don't know.
Get your jacket. Do whatever you need to do.
On it.
Come in!
Oh, wow.
You must be my 4 o'clock.
Yes, sir. Norman Crane?
Norman Crane.
Yes, sir. Okay, yeah.
Viktor Shank.
Hi.
How are you, Norman?
Very nice to meet you, Mr. Shank.
Norman, I don't know if I like that as much. I'm gonna call you Norm.
Oh, okay.
Well, I assume you're here about the position.
Yes. I hear you need a evil minion.
Yeah, just got a few quick questions for you here. First of all, I need to know what your last job was.
Ah, okay, well, I was a CPA.
So you really are evil, huh?
Well, yes. Extremely. Very passionate to the bone, the core of my bone, evil.
Why are you not CPAing anymore?
Oh, yeah, well, that's because... Wiped some rats out of the company. Created a big-time Ponzi scheme. Bigger than that guy that just had one. Went to jail for it. Yes, sir.
I'll be.
Mm-hmm. Puts him to shame. Scot-free, though. I put it away on some other people. Other schmoes.
I see.
Yeah.
Very nice.
I didn't get in trouble. I got in trouble. That's what I do. I get in trouble. Yeah.
That suit says that you don't get in very much trouble, Norman.
Oh, okay. Is it, no?
That's just not my style.
I could change whatever
you want. Moving on.
Okay, moving on.
Tell me about your family, Norm.
Oh, well, yeah, I have a lovely wife, Cynthia. Mm. A bit domineering at times, but lovely.
All women could be domineering at times. Does she work, or are you the main breadwinner?
Ah, yes. Daddy brings home the bacon. Yeah.
Damn.
I'm an old school.
You're looking for some bacon, though, huh?
Oh, I need... Daddy needs some bacon served up gristly. Ryan.
Now this next question might be the most important one. You tell me what the most evil thing you've ever done. Your whole life.
Wow, yeah, evil. Oh, it definitely have to be that time I saw a little baby eating some delicious candy, and yeah, I snatched it right out of its little hand. I said, give me that, you little snot nose. You little snot nose, that's mine.
You took candy from a baby.
Yes. Yes, I did.
Yeah. I'm gonna be pretty honest. You're not wowing me so far.
Okay.
You're not very evil, are you?
Yes. No.
I mean, your suit is telling me how not evil you are.
Yeah. I will do what it takes. You know, I may not be the most evil guy, but I'm a quick learner, and I'm sure under your tutelage, I will shoot to the fiery pits of hell.
I'll tell you what I'll do. There's a task. I'm looking for a jewel. It's the Eye of Laveau.
Ooh. Kind of voodoo-y, huh?
You find the jewel, you find the eye, you bring it to me. And you're in. Whole package. 401k, 2 weeks paid vacation.
I was gonna ask about that.
I'm pretty lenient about days off, so long as you give me some time in advance.
Oh yeah, of course.
Like, I make sure I'm not doing anything too terrible that I can't do by myself.
Yes, sir. Good business relationship is about communication. Well, you consider that Eye of Laveau yours, sir.
Norm, you don't let me down now, okay?
While Victor was in his lair recruiting new minions above Kate Street Pub, out on the streets, the people were celebrating Cinco de Mayo with a block party, a big event the news media was even there to cover the taco-eating contest. And of course, if there's free food, you'll find homeless Larry.
2, 3, go! Oh, there's some taco-eating going on now, folks. Don't those tacos look delicious? They should be savoring those tacos. Come on, guys, eat like you mean it. Cheer them on, guys, let's hear you cheer them on. Tacos. Everybody loves La Carreta tacos. Aren't they delicious? And the time is up. Time is up. Put your tacos down. Put your tacos down. No more eating. No more eating. Melissa, I'd like you to go and count the tacos, please. Let's give it up for all our contestants, though, for gorging themselves for our entertainment. Thank you. The official count is underway, folks, and she is very scrupulous. How to do the Pee Wee Herman dance. Anybody?
Holmes Larry, 5 times this week. Let's go.
I think Holmes Larry was putting tacos in his pocket.
My prayers have been answered. I asked the Lord to send me a fine brunette, and this is what walks in the Man Shack Bay. Sweetheart, have you ever considered it? Full-time career in escortery.
Excuse me. Hi. I am looking for Mr. Ron.
Steele. Ron Steele. I know him. I know him. He is a great friend of mine. He is a great friend. We work together. I'm on the radio station. Do you want to see him now? You're looking for him now? Because, I mean, he's on the radio, but we can go up there. Well, let's do it. My name is Chester. We can go now. You can just follow me.
Sweet Ron, your pizza's probably cold by now.
It's all right, baby. That's not why I ordered it.
Sweet Ron. Hi.
Whoa.
Hi.
Are you lost? Because heaven's a long way from here.
I think so. I think I'm at the wrong place. I'm looking for a Mr. Ron Steele of Steele Detectives.
That's me, Ron Steele. People call me Sweet Ron around here. Be right with you in 1 second. All right, that was a 2-hour block of uninterrupted music, and looks like we may have another 2 hours of uninterrupted music. You know, this time I might even try for 3, Ben Shack Bay. So, what can I help you with? Wait, before you get started, let me just say that you must be a parking ticket girl, because you got fine written all over you.
Really?
So what's the problem?
Okay.
My brother was just, his body was just recently found next to the railroad tracks. I don't know if you've heard about it, but on him, he had a jewel. The jewel was taken to Perkins Jewelry, and now it has been stolen. I need your help because I personally think the cops have something to do with it. So that's why I need you.
What is this jewel? Why don't you describe it to me? What is it?
It's supposed to have some kind of special powers. It's been in my family for generations, but it none of that matters. I just really need your help. So can you help me?
You got money?
Yeah, I'll pay anything.
You got yourself a detective. Oh, so my magic watch tells me you're not wearing any underwear.
Not that it's any of your business, but I am wearing underwear, thank you.
Oh, it must be an hour ahead.
Okay, on that note, I will keep in touch. Thank you.
You're welcome. Mr. Pancakes, how are you doing? Well, it looks like a new case just fell into my lap. It's got Viktor Shank written all over it. Listen, why don't you go and check out his men. Keep an eye on them. See what they're up to. All right, Petey. You're the man.
Sweet Ron, this is Petey Pancakes. I think you need to talk to homeless Larry.
Minions!
Yeah, boss?
Yeah, boss.
I want you two to meet.
Hi, Norm.
Norm?
Yeah.
Norm is Norm.
He's interested.
Norm. Nice to meet you. Nice to
okay.
meet you.
Okay.
And joining the team.
Wait.
We're our team.
Yeah, do we really need another team member?
Look, I told you two that this was the last straw. If you weren't the best bass player this side of Tallahassee, I'd have killed you years ago. And if you didn't play drums like King Kong's uncle, I would have offed you too.
You guys are in a band, huh?
Yeah, Thursday nights at Taco Hut.
Oh, yeah, I love the Taco Hut. I'll have to check that out.
Burrito specials.
Norm's gonna help you guys recover the jewel.
He's not even wearing black.
He's very handsome, though.
Thank you.
We're working on the wardrobe. But I need you guys to tell Norm all the details about the heist. Tell him exactly when the last second you remember having the jewel. Tell him everything about it in full detail. And we'll start there.
While you're out there, you know, can you keep your eyes peeled, you know, for you know, like a really nice dark little hat? I can't find my hat.
Oh,
I
feel that's horrible. Okay.
Yeah, sure. Just run across the hat.
If you happen to come across another sparkly shirt, I mean, this is nice.
What's wrong with that one?
But I've been wearing it a lot.
Look! Okay. If you happen to come across my jewel, I might not kill you guys.
The jewel is paramount, sir. Yeah. That is the number one. I will be on that. And if I happen to come across a hat, I'll
all right, enough, I get it. Get out of my sight, go. Tell him what you have to tell. Yes, you go with them. Go, right, now,
she
go.
She made me level
92.3.
Whoa. How's it going, bro?
What's happening?
Oh, I got a case, a new case. I got to get a little information on a homeless Larry, and we all know the best way to lube up homeless Larry, a little bit of the old sauce.
A little bit of the old sauce, this stuff. You know how much this costs a bottle? A little bit of sauce.
I never pay for it.
Of course you don't pay for it, Ron. I pay for it, okay? Just like I pay for the apartment you live in above the bar.
Chester pays the rent.
Well, Chester works for me, okay? So technically I'm paying that too.
Fair enough.
And you just help yourself to everything around here. My booze, my bartenders, my truck. You know what? Speaking of my truck, give my keys back, Ron. It's all scratched up. You've been running into trash cans every time you drive my truck. You're wearing it out. You need to get your own ride, man. Get yourself together.
I'll figure something out.
I know you will, bro. I'm trying to come. I had a rough day, man. I'm not trying to come down on you, okay? Look, I'll help you out, but this is not the way to go about this, okay? I mean, this costs a lot of money.
You got something better?
Do I have something better? I know what Larry likes, and it don't need to be the good stuff. I don't know, old homeless Larry has an affinity for the cherry schnapps. I don't sell much of that.
Yeah, I wonder why. Cherry schnapps, huh?
Cherry schnapps.
What the heck?
Look, bro, I love you. Just be a little more considerate, all right?
Insurance?
Chester Wolf? He ordered this on eBay.
Oh, I'm Chester Wolf. I'm Chester.
Keys are in it. I think I'm gonna have a beer.
Knock yourself out.
That's how things just go for Sweet. Needs a new set of wheels, and boom, there it is. Needs some money, no problem. Of course, the ladies have always been good to Sweet Ron. That's why they call him Sweet, because the ladies are sweet on Ron. Aren't many places to find a homeless man in Man Shack Bay, but you can bet Ron knows all of them. Yeah, he'll search around, he'll poke around, he'll do what it takes to find homeless Larry. Sweet Ron always finds this man.
Someone give me something for my head. I think I'm better off in bed. I said I'd never do it again. Every now and then.
This man loves Jerry Schnapps. Ron's loaded with a bottle of it, and he's going to get the information he needs. You can count on it.
Homeless Larry, get out here.
Sweet Ron Steele, how you doing?
I'm good.
What can I do for you?
Listen, Larry, I know you were in the alley last night. I know you saw something. Maybe a giant crystal jewel.
I've seen something.
I don't know what you're talking
about. Jewel what?
These two idiots came through and you might have seen something. You might have found a little something.
There's a guy named Norm. I found him and I traded. His name was Norm. He's this tall. He's kind of just a regular physique. I don't know. I traded him and I traded it. I'm sorry. That's all I know about him though.
All right. What do you mean you traded it? Traded it for what?
I traded it for a house. Yeah.
Traded for a house.
Yeah, come check it out.
You live in an alley.
No, not anymore. Yeah, no, I traded it.
You traded it. For this.
Right?
Oh my God.
Yes, homeless Larry's got a house. Come check it out. Jacuzzi. I got, dance studio right here. You know, just kind of practicing moves. And I had a guy, he owed me a favor. Best landscaper in town, hooked me up with a great job.
Larry, do you realize how much that thing was worth? You could have got...
Yeah, a house!
No, you could have got at least two whole bottles of cherry schnapps for that.
Two whole bottles?
Full. So,
full bottles?
Oh, yeah. Yep.
But it's my house.
So, yeah.
At least come inside and get a drink.
No, I'm good.
Well...
Well, you see, homeless Larry, I love capitalism.
Oh, man, it's about bartering. It's about exchanges.
But money makes the world go round.
You're talking to a man who has a mansion now because of exchanges.
Mansions of their own.
I mean, your argument has a whole lot of water. Oh, hello.
Thinking of holding water.
Right. Look, I don't know if you heard, but I have a mansion.
Do you smell like cold cut?
No.
What are you doing? Calling the police?
No, I'm not calling.
Oh, the light on Main Street's up. Oh, the ethnic kids are too loud for the neighborhood. Oh, my 5-year-old's been missing 48 hours. Nobody's coming!
What's happening,
Chester?
Man?
What are you doing there?
I'm a little frustrated, to be honest with you.
What's wrong?
You wouldn't even believe it if I told you.
I'm trying to.
I bought a car off of eBay, and this guy is telling me that he has a copy of a piece of paper with my signature saying that it was signed and delivered, you know? And I don't have a car. I've been riding my bicycle for years, and I finally saved up the money to get a car, and now he's telling me this, and I just don't even know what to do. I'm very confused and frustrated, and I'm venting my frustrations via Gmail.
Tough break.
Well. Hello, Norm.
Hello, boss.
Now, that's an excellent wardrobe choice.
Thank you.
That's more
thank
like
you.
It. I like
was worried
to see
about
that.
Impressing you with the... You don't think the velvet was too much?
Oh, I'm a big fan of velvet.
Good, good.
I thought he
would. Who is this enchanting lady?
This is my wife, Cynthia.
You can call me Cindy.
Charmed to meet you.
I made you a pie.
Yummy. Is that?
Blackbird.
My favorite. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
So, Norm.
We'll talk.
Do you have an update for me about that business we discussed earlier today?
Well, I just might have a little something for you. Nice shot, boss.
Welcome to the team.
Pretty fly tonight. I like that big gun.
Sweet Ron.
Sweet Ron.
Hey, pretty ladies, I hope you brought your sex. Sweet Ron Steele is in the mood, so you know what happens next.
Sweet Ron.
He's the smoothest private dick this world has ever seen. Charming panties off all the ladies, from grandmas to preteens.
Sweet Ron!
I think that's illegal, Sweet Ron.
You make me feel so good.
Sweet Ron!
Solving all the crimes each day and always getting all the play.
He packs a pistol, but it's not his only gun. Time to get in line, ladies, cause Ron won't settle for one.
Sweet Ron!
Depending on the season, he'll do two or three at a time.
Open season.
Please them all individually, and then go solve that crime.
Sweet Ron!
Yeah, Sweet Ron. Coming to solve your crimes, baby. All your crimes of love.
Sweet Ron!
Solving all the crimes each day and
all
always
your crimes
getting
of
all the passion.
Sweet Ron! Sweet Ron!
They call him sweet, but don't get in his way. Especially when he's had too much cavassie.
He's got a problem, baby.
But you can't blame him. You know he's staying alive.
Yeah.
And bringing you smooth drive time, grooves from 3 to 5.
Sweet Ron!
Yeah, kick back,
and
baby.
Now you make me
put your feet up,
so
Sweet Ron.
Good.
Taking you home.